most of you are probably used to the way that Windows handles hard drives. Under Windows, each physical hard drive gets its own letter. Most familiar is the C drive, which usually represents the main hard drive for the computer that you're working on. If you were to add a second drive, it would be possible that that second drive would be given the letter D. Optical drives also receive letters. This idea can be valuable because it's pretty easy to say, well, if I'm on the C drive, I'm dealing with this hard drive, and if I'm on the D drive, I'm dealing with this hard drive. But with that said, you also need to have some level of knowledge of the underlying system. Unix takes a different approach. In Unix, all of the drives in a machine are mapped under a single directory called root. And what that does is it makes it really nice because it makes it look like all of the hard drives in the machine are a single storage unit. Now, this doesn't stripe the drives together. This doesn't do anything like RAID. It doesn't do anything fancy. But what it does do is it represents to the user separate drives as just folders underneath of a common top-level hierarchy. And so there's no need to think like, oh, is that file on the C drive? All you have to do is remember the directory it's in. And you don't really have to worry about the actual drive that it's on, data is on. In this case, the root directory is represented by a forward slash. So whenever I say, let's go to the root directory of our Unix system, what I'm saying is, let's go to the directory represented by slash. In Unix, there's a couple of different ways that we can refer to files. The terms that I'll use are absolute and relative paths, and so we need to kind of know the difference between the two of these. When you give an absolute path, you are actually giving a full description of where to find the file, starting at the root directory. So whenever you give someone an absolute path on Unix, you always start with root, home, slash, json, slash, stuff. And that's the directory that I've got listed here. So the reason why this is absolute is I'm saying go back up to the topmost level directory and start from there to find the file. In Windows, if you were to give an absolute path, it would start with a drive letter like C colon, home, whatever. So the idea is that absolute paths always start with the root directory. We can also give relative paths in Unix. And relative paths are based on where you currently are located within the file system. So you can say, you know, based on where I currently am, go up a directory or go down a directory and get this file. So absolute paths always start with root. Relative paths are given in relationship to where you are within the file system, hence the name relative. And we'll talk a little bit more about how you navigate relative and absolute paths when we talk about commands like cd. Once we get into actually navigating the file system. So what does a file structure look like on Unix? Well, I've kind of broken this down into a file hierarchy tree. And one of the things you have to get used to on Unix is that you need to keep a mental representation of where you are within the file system. One of the nice things about graphical user interfaces is that they use, you know, obviously using the folder metaphor allows us to have a visual representation of this idea that one folder is inside of another folder. So in this case, if I were to give you the absolute path to where MP3s are stored, I would say, okay, root, home, JSON, MP3. And what this says is the MP3 directory or folder is inside of the JSON directory or folder, and the JSON directory or folder is inside of the home directory or folder, and the home directory or folder, you know, I'll say directory, but I'll say home folder and directory, so we could start thinking in terms of directories, is underneath the root directory. If I said, hey, we are currently located in the JSON directory, what is the relative path to the bin directory? Well, you would say go up one directory to home, then go up another directory to the root, and then jump into the bin directory. So you could define a path relative to the bin directory as being relative to the JSON directory. So again, this idea of relative versus absolute paths. Commands in Unix follow a very standard pattern. Although as soon as I tell you that there's a rule, immediately you're going to find commands that break it. But for the most part, every command in Unix follows this general syntax. So what we're going to have is the actual command name itself, followed by a dash and a series of options. Later on, you'll see sometimes where some commands don't require this dash, and that some commands, instead of single letter options, will take full word, easily readable options. But the general syntax of options is that it's a single letter followed by preceded by a dash. And then at the end of the command, we're going to see a number of arguments, zero or more arguments that feed into the command. So let's take a look at what this looks like in an actual command. The ls command is a command for listing the contents of a directory. So ls is the command. Dash l is the option for that command, and that will list all of the items in the directory in a long format. And then finally, the argument for this command is slash etc, which is a directory. So what I'm basically doing is I'm saying, okay, ls is the command, dash l is the option, and the argument that I'm feeding into this command is slash etc. And if you think about it, if I want to list a directory, I need to have the name of the directory to list. And when I list a directory, I might want to have some different ways to view that information. So one would be a long listing. One might just be a brief listing. One might be file names only. One might give me, instead of byte counts for file sizes, human readable megabytes and kilobytes. So this is the general format for syntax, and in every following video, we're going to be seeing how this is put into action.